Welcome back, everybody, to our mid-holiday live special. And we have a very, very special guest joining us. Yay! Of course, this is Barbara Nico. This is Mark's wife. And we're so happy to have you with us this morning.
Hi, honey.
How are you guys?
Honey, we are having a good time. Listen.
Oh, your scrubs look fantastic today, sweetie.
Especially the mask now. The mask face. I'm sure you love it.
Mask ring. All right, let me set this up real quick before you tell us what it is. So I grew up in St. Louis for the most part, moved to Atlanta and met my wife there. And she's like, you have to try this sweet potato casserole. And I'm like, no, I don't. We didn't have that growing up. I'm like, you mean yams? And she's like, no.
Mike.
This is not yams. You need to try this. And I, how many dinners did I pass before I finally tried it? I'm like, why didn't you twist my arm sooner?
Nice. Many, many, many meals. But I finally brought you around. You're in now, so that's all that matters.
Well, usually this is the sweetest thing on the dish, but I think here it's not going to be, but it is still so good. It's almost like a dessert itself. Tell us about it, sweetie.
Well, there is a lot of butter. You know, you can't be in the South without butter.
Amen.
But instead of putting marshmallows on like most people do on the sweet potato, I do candied pecans. So it's good. You'll like it.
Okay.
Oh, we're liking it.
That's a good choice.
I am liking it, Barbara. Yes, my Atlanta sis. That's what I'm saying.
I try to make it a little healthier, you know, with the nuts instead of the marshmallows. It's at least got some protein in it, right?
Yeah.
This is good.
The marshmallows would trash it up. This is it.
I like the crunch. It gives it like a nice crunch, and then like the casserole down here is soft. This is good.
It's very much a textural thing, isn't it?
Yes.
I love it.
Really layered dish.
And depending on how much.
See, I want the drink you guys had. the little shot.
Leanne
better be bringing me some home.
Yes, Leanne made some for Mike, so don't let him take that bottle from you.
What? She did?
She did.
That's going to be happy hour for you, Barbara.
It's in the refrigerator. It's for you, Barbara.
It sounds like a plan, I tell you.
You know I got to get my hair cut first, and then I'll be right home. I know.
All right,
I'm going to make you wait an hour.
Barbara, let me describe to you your night, okay? This man's going to get his hair cut. You get this coquito. You settle in, you turn on the Sex and the City reboot, and then you just have a good evening.
I have got to watch that reboot. I started watching it, and then the boys came in, and it went off. So I got to get back in there. Yes. I got to see it.
That happens.
Have you seen it, Reggie?
Yeah, this whole crew, we're watching it.
I know, and I can't talk to them about it because I haven't watched with you yet.
Oh, so you're going to watch
with me? The show.
Of course.
He's going to watch.
Okay. All right, that's our night.
Thank you, Barbara. This was delicious.
It really is good.
It really is good. And I'm glad you enjoyed it. Your own with the nuts on the top.
Tell Dr. Cole thank you for letting you join us.
Thank you, Doc.
I will.
We'll brush our teeth later, we promise.
Barbara. Yes, exactly. With all that sugar, you need to be brushing.
Thank you. And flossing. Barbara, always a pleasure to see you. When we come back. Nice to see